subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Uzma Jafri with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show with India, which has announced a whopping $267 billion economic package for the country amid the rapidly spreading pandemic of COVID-19. New Delhi has rolled out a list of economically beneficial schemes aimed at making up for the losses people have incurred during crisis and to give a boost to the revival of their trade and businesses. After three lockdowns of around 8 weeks, the country has also decided to ease restrictions in phased manner. While the economic sector will be resumed partially, other industries will operate with limited workforce.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced a 20 trillion Indian rupee or $267 billion support package for India's economy to help mitigate the damage caused by novel coronavirus and the lockdown it has triggered. The decision was taken as India's government is starting to pull back from one of world's tightest lockdowns of 1.3 billion people that has left millions out of work and stranded in cities far from home while infections keep rising. Now, India is one among those countries that have spent 10 or more percent of their GDP to recover from major economic dent they have endured due to the pandemic. Prime Minister said that his government is looking to provide strength to every section of the Indian economy.
This package भारत की जीडीपी का करीब करीब 10% है. इन सबके जरिए देश के विभिन्न वर्गों को आर्थिक व्यवस्था की कड़ियों को 20 लाख करोड़ रुपए का संबल मिलेगा, सपोर्ट मिलेगा.
India's manufacturing output contracted by more than a fifth in March from a year earlier, driven by the closure of thousands of factories during the lockdown. Industrial output, which includes manufacturing and mining, contracted 16.7% in March from a year earlier.
Lockdown ka chautha charan. Lockdown 4. पूरी तरह नए रंग रूप वाला होगा, नए नियमों वाला होगा. राज्यों से हमें जो सुझाव मिल रहे हैं उनके आधार पर लॉकडाउन 4, इससे जुड़ी जानकारी भी आपको 18 मई से पहले दी जाएगी.
The decision was hailed across the business class and commoners across the country. Everyone supported the decision, saying that such a huge economic package will definitely support the economy that has suffered a massive setback in past few weeks. It wasn't just the people, but the market too soared the following day. The NSE Nifty 50 index rose 2.68% to 9,441.55, while the S&P BSE Sensex was 2.80% higher at 32,254.16. India has come up with an elaborate plan to support the small and medium enterprises that have been severely impacted.
There is a collateral-free automatic loan for MSMEs which is being provided. This will give facility up to 3 lakh crores. There are no guarantee fees, no fresh collaterals required. So I guess this will benefit 45 lakh units so that they can resume their business activity and also safeguard jobs.
While India has put a special focus on the return of the migrant workers to their homes, particularly in the last few days, the Finance Ministry has rolled out a special plan for them. The government aims to help them monetarily by including them in the MGNREGA scheme that guarantees employment to the unemployed. The migrant workers will also be getting a special concession at the purchase of homes in coming times. Meanwhile, industries in part of India have resumed their operations following strict government guidelines. Smartphone maker Lava is among the early birds to have restarted partial manufacturing at its factory on the outskirts of New Delhi with barely 600 of its 3,500 workforce. Factories are being allowed to operate with roughly one-fifth of their capacity with stringent guidelines to maintain social distancing and hygiene standards. World's biggest lockdown, along the extensive government campaign of social distancing and hygiene, have so far given positive results. Against the projections made by scientists and experts of India crossing the mark of 1 million by mid-May, the country has so far contained the spread and the numbers stand just over 80,000.
Moving on, India's evacuation operation has picked up pace, with both its airbuses and ships continuously bringing back its stranded citizens from different countries. Even the migrants who are stuck in several cities and towns across the country are returning to their homes with government's initiatives. Along with this, India is also extending its helping hand to other countries to fight COVID-19 pandemic by sending its medical personnel. We have a report.
Under its mission Vande Bharat of mass evacuation through ships, two warships of Indian Navy, INS Jalashwa and INS Magar, have evacuated hundreds of its nationals stranded in various countries. While INS Jalashwa brought back 698 Indian nationals, INS Magar brought 202 Indians from the capital of Maldives, Male, that docked in Kochi city of Kerala. Though India suspended all international flights from March 22nd to curb the spread of coronavirus, the country began phased repatriation of its citizens stranded abroad during the corona crisis from May 7th.
Our second platform, landing ship tank INS Magar, departed Male on the 10th of May with 202 Indian nationals and entered Kochi just a short while ago. Currently, she is disembarking her passengers to go through the screening process themselves.
As a part of India's massive repatriation drive, two flights from Kuala Lumpur and Dhaka also landed in the country carrying more than 350 Indian nationals.
We were facing many problems, like we वहाँ खाना नहीं मिल रहा था and many other problems like day-to-day stuffs जो हमें जो day-to-day ज़रूरी आ रही थी वो नहीं मिल पा रही थी because of the lockdown जो वहाँ पे भी थे but thanks to SK Bhatia, that is the foreign assistant foreign minister जिन्हें हमारी बहुत help की वहाँ पे.
The Indian government is not just helping the distressed Indians in other countries but also those who got stuck in several cities and towns across country during the coronavirus lockdown. These migrant workers are now returning to their hometown in Shramik special trains that are being run by Indian Railways. At New Delhi Railway Station, Long queues of passengers were seen who returned from 12 cities including Mumbai, Chennai and Bengaluru. The passengers went through a thermal scanning at both the stations, New Delhi and Mumbai, and maintained decorum. Meanwhile, in Nasik city of Maharashtra too, migrant workers queued up to board special train deployed to carry them to their home in Madhya Pradesh.
इनमें सब जो नासिक ग्रामीण के जो लोग हैं जो यहाँ पे काम करते वहाँ पे जाना चाहते थे उनकी सब रजिस्ट्रेशन जो किया है उनका रजिस्ट्रेशन करने के बाद वो ट्रेन बुक करके विशेष ट्रेन से उनको रवाना किया गया है.
India is not just making efforts to help its stranded citizens, be it in the country or outside, to reach their home. But it is also extending its support to other countries as well. In one such initiative, India has dispatched its first batch of nurses to the UAE in efforts to fight COVID-19 pandemic. The batch containing 88 nurses was sent by a healthcare company from Kerala, with Indian consulate and UAE's foreign ministry also involved in the process. The nurses had been trained in Indian hospitals for critical patients and will join the UAE's healthcare efforts.
ഈ ഒരു ദുബായ് കോവിഡ് കേസിലേക്ക് ഭാഗമാവാൻ പറ്റിയതിൽ ഞാൻ വളരെ സന്തോഷിക്കുന്നു. കാരണം ആസ് എ നേഴ്സ് എന്ന നിലയിൽ എൻ്റെ ലൈഫിൽ ഏറ്റവും ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുന്ന ഒരു ഹാപ്പിനെസ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു കാര്യം എന്ന് പറയുന്നതാണ് ഇപ്പോൾ ഇവിടെ വരിക എന്നുള്ളതും ഒരു കൊറോണ പേഷ്യൻറ്റിനെ കെയർ ചെയ്യുക എന്നുള്ളത്.
ഇന്ത്യ is also constantly making efforts to keep in loop with the world to combat COVID-19. Recently, Indian Foreign Minister Subramaniam Jaishankar took part in the meeting of finance ministers of Shanghai Cooperation Organization via video conferencing and discussed ways on combating the corona outbreak.
Moving on. Bangladesh is having a hard time in dealing with the increased number of coronavirus cases. People in the densely packed Dhaka slums are living under a constant threat of contracting the virus as the deadly disease continues to spread its tentacles in the capital. Extreme poverty and lack of information means that some slum dwellers may not be fully aware of the grim situation in the country. But almost all are feeling its impact. We have a report.
A large number of people in Bangladesh's capital Dhaka are living at high risk of contracting the deadly coronavirus as the contagion has spread to almost all parts of the city. Many of them are at the low rung of socio-economic ladder and they are neither equipped with masks and sanitizers to protect themselves nor they have enough knowledge about the virus. Many of them work as rickshaw pullers, daily wage laborers or domestic helpers and have been without a job during the pandemic. Their houses are overpopulated where 6 to 8 people are forced to live in a single room.
আর এখানে আমরা এক মানে পাশাপাশি অনেক মানুষই থাকি কিন্তু আমাদের বাধ্য হয়ে থাকতে হয় করোনা আমরা জানি করোনা বাংলাদেশে আছে কিন্তু হইলে কি আমাদের সবাই তো একপাশে মানে একসাথেই থাকা লাগে আর ওই মাথা থেকে এই মাথা বন্ধু এখন পর্যন্ত কোনো করোনা রোগী পাওয়া যায় নাই বুঝছেন আর কোনো ডাক্তার ডুকারও আমাদের এখানে আসে নাই যে কোনো পরীক্ষা করবে.
This is Mohakhali Kurel slum in Dhaka, where more than 100,000 people are going about their daily lives without face mask and without maintaining social distancing. The outbreak of the contagion hasn't seemingly had any impact on them. They can be seen roaming and gossiping without any fear from the disease that claimed around 300,000 lives across the globe. The country itself has registered nearly 20,000 cases and 300 deaths, with number growing rapidly after an increase in the testing. However, the thing they are worried most about is the lockdown as they haven't been able to earn anything in the past few weeks.
বাংলাদেশে করোনা আইছে, এই করোনার ইয়ে আমরা খুব কষ্টে আছি। বাইরেতে না খাওয়া দাওয়া করতাম না, কোনো কাজকর্ম নাই, আমরা অনেক অসুবিধায় আছি। আমরা বয়তে অনেক চলাফেরা করতারি না, কোনো কাজকর্ম করতারি না, খাইতারি না, আমরা গরমেতে থাকি, বাইরেতেরই না।
Nearly 650,000 people reside in around 3,400 slums in the capital. Now, they all are at risk of contracting virus. The potential of healthcare system in Bangladesh is limited, and they are bound to be overwhelmed with flu patients who are expected to grow exponentially in coming times.
এখানে ঘনবসতি প্রত্যেকটা রুমের মধ্যে 5-7 জন 10 জন করে থাকেন। গরিব মানুষ পেডের তাগিতে তারা করোনারও ভয় পায় না, তারা এই পেডের তাগিতে আছে আর কি, বাধ্য হয়ে থাকতে হয়েছে করোনা। তবে এই এলাকা করোনা ভাইরাসের এখন রোগী মনে হয় শনাক্ত হয় নাই আমরা জানা মতনে, তবে সম্ভাবনা আছে স্যার, মানে রিক্সের মধ্যে আছে।
While some sectors of Bangladesh economy have reopened, the country has decided to extend its lockdown until 30th May. Bangladesh first declared a nationwide holiday from March 26 to April 4, while the country confirmed the first coronavirus death on March 18, 10 days after the detection of the first three COVID-19 cases. The government had extended the lockdown several times to 16 May at the earliest, but eased some curbs such as allowing factories to reopen. Some shopping malls have also resumed trading ahead of Eid. But all educational institutions have remained closed, so has public transit system.
While a section of society in Pakistan has accused Islamabad of discrimination, a vivid example of what could be deemed persecution has emerged from the illegally occupied territory of Gilgit-Baltistan. While some businessmen who are close to establishment have been given a green flag to resume their daily economic activities, others who are considered second-class citizens are still not allowed to open their shops. These people have come out in large numbers against the authorities. They have also urged the administration to allow their markets to open, else they will hold bigger protests. A report.
Shopkeepers in NLI market held protest against the discrimination by local administration amid lockdown in the occupied Gilgit-Baltistan. They blamed the authorities for allowing shops in other markets to remain open with designated time, but their shops are closed for over a month. Named after the Northern Light Infantry or NLI Regiment of Pakistan Army, the market is where one can find Chinese goods from clothes to calculators.
मैं अभी सब्जी मंडी से होके आया हूँ। आप ये देखें सब्जी मंडी में इतना जमघटा है, वहाँ कोरोना नहीं आता है क्या? मस्जिदों में मुतालिबा किया, मस्जिदों के बारे में मुतालिबा किया कि वहाँ कोरोना आता है तो हमने फासला रखा है। आप जाएं एनालाइज मार्केट के अंदर, ऐसे लोग भी हैं जो अपना गुजारा कर रहे थे। सारा कश्मीरी बाजार खुला है, ये पीछे आप जाए खुला है, तो मैं अभी कशरोट से आया हूँ, पूरा कशरोट तकरीबन खुला है, बड़ी कंपनियां, बाटा शूज खुला है, उसके अलावा सर्विस शूज भी खुला है। वहाँ इंसान रहते हैं क्या? ये कश्मीरी बाजार एनालाइज में इंसान नहीं रहते हैं क्या? इनके बच्चे नहीं हैं? ये हुकूमत है वक्त से, हम फेडरल हुकूमत से भी ये मुतालबा करेंगे और सूबाई हुकूमत से भी हम यही मुतालबा करें, अगर कानून लाना तो एक कानून लाएं, नहीं तो हम आएंगे रोड पे, फिर हमें कोई नहीं रोक सकता।
It's not just that the business activities of the traders have stopped due to lockdown and a discriminatory treatment by the administration, but these people are also forced to feed the dependents such as workers whom they have employed with them. The administration has not paid any heed. People say that they will also not be able to pay the loans they have received on heavy interest as there are no earnings. They have urged the administration to open the market at the earliest, as a further delay will push them towards alternatives and they will take to streets against the government.
क्या कहना लाए वाले हैं? कोई इंसान नहीं है तो ये क्या है? हमारे साथ क्या जुर्म हो रहा है? ये सिर्फ इन लाई वालों के साथ यही जुर्म है तो फिर ठीक है। कोरोना वाले सिर्फ इन लाई में हैं,
Out of the around total 38,000 cases in Pakistan, the occupied Gilgit-Baltistan has so far reported 442 cases, while Pakistan-occupied Kashmir has 86 COVID-19 cases. Gilgit-Baltistan is bordering China's Xinjiang province, where a large number of Chinese engineers and workers are engaged in construction of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor projects.
Moving on. The economy of almost all the countries has been severely hit by the spread of the virus. The governments have no option but to resume the daily economic activity. However, while the countries like India and Sri Lanka have been very cautious in taking such decisions, others have gone ahead with lifting lockdowns without deliberation. Pakistan has eased even the limited restrictions at a time when the number of cases has just picked up pace. Testing is limited and the experts are not satisfied with the government's move, but Imran government has paid little heed.
Pakistan, which has received flak for being too liberal on religious gatherings amid coronavirus outbreak, has now got away with major portion of its lockdown. Despite the country reporting some of their biggest daily increases in new infections recently, Pakistan has started easing its lockdown. In just 3 days of easing the restrictions, the cases have gone past 37,000, with death toll going past 800. Although schools will remain shut until mid-July, a decision on reopening intercity transport would be made later. However, keeping in view the abrupt decisions the administration has made so far, a complete resumption is not that far. People in Pakistan have a low per capita income, and the government hasn't been able to provide them with any substantial relief package amid the spread of the virus. Shopkeepers in Lahore have hailed the decision, saying 7-week lockdown has severely affected their livelihood.
इंशाल्लाह ताला हमें उम्मीद है दुकानदार जैसे 50 दिन के बाद दुकानें खोली हैं वो पूरा इस पे अमल करेंगे हमने भी इसीलिए सैनिटाइजर बाहर भी रखा है दुकानों पे लड़कों ने सर्वरों ने ग्लव भी पहने हुए हैं मास्क भी पहने हुए हैं अपनी तरफ से पूरी एहतियात करें कस्टमर जो आएगा उसको हम यही कह रहे हैं जी मास्क पहन के अंदर आए जी
While some have hailed the decisions, others complain that they have been kept out of the system without any rationale behind the decision. The government's handling of the virus has been strongly criticized by scientists and doctors who fear the outbreak will gather more base among a population of around 210 million and overwhelm the country's struggling health system. Some of the locals even said behind the camera that the administration has blindly followed the steps taken by other countries without actually following the measures taken by them.
किरियाना मार्केट्स के अंदर आप चले जाएं वहाँ पे कोरोना नहीं है मेडिकल मार्केट के अंदर कोरोना नहीं है तो क्या कोरोना किसी भी आप मॉल्स के अंदर ही है आप हुकूमत से हमारा इल्तिजा है कि खुदा रहा आप मॉल्स को भी आप इजाज़त दे दें हम भी आप एस ओ पीज पर अमल करेंगे
द आइलैंड नेशन ऑफ श्रीलंका टू हैज ईज रिस्ट्रिक्शंस आफ्टर वीक्स ऑफ स्ट्रॉन्ग विजिल एंड टफ लॉकडाउन Businesses, public transportation and government departments gradually reopened in Sri Lankan capital of Colombo as authorities relaxed a lockdown which began in mid-March. Social distancing was enforced on public transport while government employees were required to wash their hands and undergo temperature checks before entering offices.
අපි මාස දෙකක් තිස්සේ මේ වැඩපොළවල් වහලා තිබ්බේ මේ කොරෝනා රෝගියත් එක්ක අපිට රජයේ නිකුත් කරා මේ වැඩපොළවල් අරින්න කියලා ඉතින් රජයට කියපු ආකාරයට මේ නීති අනුව අපි වැඩපොළ කරගෙන යනවා පෞගිය කාලේ අපිට ආර්ථික ප්‍රශ්න සෑහෙන්න තිබ්බා ආර්ථිකය වැටිලා බිස්නස් වැල්ලා ඉතින් අපිට ගොඩක් සතුටුයි මාස දෙකකට පසුව හරි අපිට මේ ආයතනය කරගෙන වැඩ කරන්න මාර්ගය සලසා දීම ගැන අපිට ගොඩක් සතුටුයි
Curfews will continue to be observed in some places in some districts of the country The island nation, which is heavily dependent on tourism, has reported 925 confirmed cases of COVID-19 and 9 deaths so far. For government departments in Colombo, only a third of the original workforce will be allowed to return to offices. Private businesses have also been asked to scale down their number of employees at the workplace.
After a brief relaxation, Sri Lanka has even decided to put country into lockdown once again from Sunday to check the spread. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.